Android 11 is here. It's the next version of Android, and Google's releasing a super early preview of it for developers this year. Now, the changes here are really developer-facing. There's not a lot of stuff that you're gonna see if you're a user. But Google's making some big promises. We've got support for 5G, better foldable phone support, new improved privacy and storage stuff. One thing to keep in mind, this is really a preview for developers only, and I mean really, like even more so than other years. You can only install it on a Pixel 2, 3, 3A, or 4, or the XL versions, and to install it, you need to completely nuke your device. Just don't do it, guys. Just don't, trust me on this. But if you are a developer, or you're like us and you happen to have a spare Pixel lying around, you can install the Android 11 developer preview today. And there's still not a whole lot of stuff. Again, all the big, cool, exciting changes are probably gonna come at Google I/O later this year. But there are a couple cool things, so let's dive into them. First is Bubbles. Now, it's a pretty similar feature to Facebook Messenger's Chat Heads feature, where, you know, puts the head of the person and they're floating over the screen. This is a system-level thing that, in theory, any messaging app can use. Right now, the only app that actually uses it is Google's own messaging app. But in theory, all your favorite messaging apps should be able to use it and all work together in this single, floating, bubbly pop-up. And then you can get to those messages from anywhere. Using the feature is actually really simple. You just tap and hold on a messaging notification, and there's a send to bubble thing that sends it to a bubble. And if you're using the Android 10 betas, actually, this probably should sound pretty familiar because it debuted there and then didn't make the final cut. Anyway, it's here now in Android 11. Hopefully it'll actually ship this time. To go along with Bubbles, there's the new conversation area of the notification shade, which breaks out your messages from all your other notifications like Instagram likes and emails and puts them up on top of the notification area. The idea here is that it's easier to find and continue the conversations you're having with people because it's a phone and that's what phones are for. Next up, better application permissions. Now, this sounds boring, I know, but it's actually taking a page from iOS's book, and it's actually super important. What Google's letting you do now is now when an app asks if it can use your microphone or your camera or your location data, instead of having two choices, either no or have it always, there's now a third option where you can just give it permission that just one time. So if you, you know, want to send a picture using an app, but don't want that app to have access to your camera until the end of time, that's what this is for. Screen recording. Okay, so if you've been using Android, especially the betas, we've been burned on this before, but it's here now in Android 11 in the beta. There's a screen recording UI that lets you just natively record your screen on Android. It has a much better user interface this time. It looks much nicer, and hopefully Google actually, you know, ship it this time. But again, we'll have to wait and see. Fingers crossed though. There's also a couple smaller features. Dark mode now has automated settings. You can set it to turn on and off at set times as opposed to having it, you know, be a manual process. The solely gestures on the Pixel 4 have a new one where you can wave your hand over your phone to start and stop your music. There's a new touchscreen sensitivity option, again, only on the Pixel 4 so far, that claims it'll make your touchscreen more sensitive and work better when you have a screen protector on. Also returning, I should say, is the ability to pin apps to the top of the share sheet, which is something that people have been asking for a long time. So now when you're sharing something, instead of just showing you all the apps that you have installed on your phone that you can send it to, you can just pin the ones you actually want, like, you know, messages and email right on top. Now, this being a developer beta, there's a bunch of stuff that we can't really show you yet, either because it's too abstract for us to show on a phone or because it's just not done yet. Google's promising 5G improvements, like the ability for apps to figure out if your phone really has an unlimited data connection before it burns through your whole data plan with, you know, giant 5G data usage. There's also better support for scoped storage, where Android puts apps in their own little bins where they can't interact as much. It's actually pretty similar to iOS. Now, Google introduced this last year with Android 10, but it's making a much bigger push on this year, and it's the sort of thing that will improve security. Google's also going to add a feature for if you want to turn that off, you'll be able to in some cases. Again, this is more of a developer thing, but your apps will be more secure. In things that you might actually notice, there's also going to be better support for new types of screens like foldable displays, pinhole displays, waterfall displays, weird edges. Look, Android phones are getting really interesting and really wacky, cool new designs, and Google's going to make sure that Android works with all of them, which is great. Google's also promising OS-level support for shake and stir call authentication, which should make it easier to avoid spam calls. It's working on improving low-latency video streaming for game streaming services like Google's Project Stadia. It's also promising things like Project Mainline, which lets Google update parts of the Android OS through the Play Store without having to roll out giant software updates like Android 11. Now, again, this is all really, really early stuff. There's obviously going to be much bigger features that Google will have for us later, and some of these features are even already available right now if you have, you know, Samsung or Motorola phones. But what's important here is that Google's laying the groundwork for the future of Android. When it bakes these features into the OS on a level like this, it's setting the bar for developers, both software and hardware, to build better and better phones for you in the future. And that's really exciting. Obviously, again, this is super early, and we'll have lots more on Android 11 in the coming days, weeks, and months as Google continues to roll out betas and make more announcements. But until then, stay tuned to The Verge. Thanks so much for watching. This is the Android 11 logo. They're turning it up to 11. It's very cute. You got it. I got it. They got it. I miss the dessert names. Where's the dessert names, Google? Like and subscribe to The Verge. Also do that.